Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. In this tutorial, I will show you how you can create your very own Variadic function. So let's get started. Okay, just open up a plain old Xcode project and we are going to build out a Variadic function, of course, with Variadic arguments or properties, and all of this in Swift 5. So what exactly is a Variadic function? Well, if you ever, and I am bet you did, type in print, you will see that items is of any and these three dots here. Now, that is a Variadic parameter or the print, the whole print statement is a Variadic function. And if I hit return here, you will see that we can add a variable amount of elements to this Variadic parameter. So most usually we add in here, hello. And if we hit command R and we build and run, we will see that it prints out hello, but we could add more than one element here, and that is the use case of Variadic arguments. Let's just build and run on my iPhone XR. So let's see how this works out, and build has succeeded, great. That is always a good thing. And once it is built, you can see that it's printing out here, hello. Let me just make this a little smaller so you can see. So if we wanted to, we can add another string here or any type of element, because it's of type any. And hello, Alex. And let's add in there a space. So let's build and run again and see. Hello, Alex printed out. Now, this is plain old stuff, but I bet you didn't do this as well. And because this has a separator of a space, you can see that here we have hello, Alex, and a space. So let me just show you what I'm talking about. So print, and you can see that here we have a separator and a terminator. Now the terminator is a new line, a separator is a space. So now you know. Of course, you can change the separator or the terminator if you like, but that could be for another lesson. So let us just create our very own Variadic function in Swift 5. And for that, I will just create a new file private function here. And let's see, let's add up some numbers. And I will name this sum. And let's add in here some numbers. And the numbers will be of type integer. And let's add in here the old way of how we would used to do it. Let's create this as an array of integers, and this will return an int. There we go. And now let's just loop through all of these numbers. So numbers for each, there we go, we have our number. And we just add numbers plus equals, I believe, or rather yet, let's create a sum here. So sum equals zero, and sum plus equals this new number. And then we just return our sum. And that is okay. So let's see here. Let's print out, and I will add this sum. And as you can see here, we have an array of numbers. And what we do is set 1, 2, and 3. Okay. And let's see. Oh, we need to set this to var. Okay. So let's build and run and see that actually, and the printed out sum should be 6, and indeed it is 6. And yeah, it's kind of cumbersome, you have this array, but now let's change this to a Variadic parameter. So int and three dots, And now, if we type in again, so sum, we see that numbers is a variadic parameter. You can add as many variables as you want. So let's add in here 1, 2, 3, or we could just add 1 if we wanted to. That's no problem. Okay, let's just build and run and see the same effect. We have 6. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that you can add only one variadic parameter to a function. So if you wanted to add numbers or something else besides that, we are not allowed to do that. Now, okay, this is quite straightforward, but let's create as a final example something that is pretty useful, and that will be a UI view extension. So let's see, extension UI view, and you know, when you add a subview and you have a lot of views, you have that add subview, add subview, add subview. Now I want to create a function that will add all of our views with only one line of code, and of course with the help of our variadic arguments. So let's create this variadic function. So func and add sub views with an s at the end will be our function name, and let's add in here our views, and it will be a variadic argument of UI view. There we go. These are called variadic arguments, variadic properties. Just keep in mind that it has those three dots. Okay, and yeah, that is basically it. It's not returning anything, it's just making sure that we add our subview. Okay, so for each, or rather yet, views for each, and we get here our view, and inside we want to add subview view, because basically we are adding our subviews to our view. So how would we use this? Well, it is pretty straightforward. Let's create some views here. Let view 1 equals UI view, and then let's just create some more. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And now the old way of adding this would be like view, add subview, and view 1, and then you would copy and paste all of this. So let me just show you the difference. Okay, and in some cases it's not just as simple as copy and pasting, because you have other view names. But now we can omit this and use our newly created function, like view add subviews, and now we can just simply add our views here. So view 2, view 3, and finally view 4. Now how easy is that? And it's much more readable, you don't have a lot of lines in your project. Now, that is it for variadic functions with variadic arguments or variadic parameters. I said variadic a lot in this tutorial, but I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell if you want to get notified instantly of new videos as they do come out. Now it is your turn. Go ahead and comment down below some use cases of variadic functions that you discovered or maybe you created. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.